Welcome to the 11th episode. Welcome back to Skåne. We are situated on the line to Kristianstad, but we finished two episodes ago. And we are following the train to arrive at Kristianstad. Today we will continue Landskrona and Helsingborg railways. So there will be two time lapses. The first one will focus on Landskrona, which is a larger station but not huge, and the line connecting to it. And the second time lapse that will follow directly after the first one is more about getting the details, getting the fencing, protecting the rivers, stuff like that. In order to avoid the AI to build on rivers, lakes, and farmland, because the plan is to keep it look like farmland. So that is the plan for today, and at the end we will also see how the station layouts around Helsingborg ended up, because as we saw in the last episode, it is a complete spaghetti everything, basically, and there just isn't any room to put them in. So, after spending two nights, many hours trying to figure it out, it ended up being a rather meek compromise, I guess, but that's what had to happen. This time, I guess. So that's the plan for today, and so we will continue on the forced marriage route, so to say, and the plan is to finish it rather soon. So as we roll into the station here, we are ready for the first time lapse. Thank you. So this is what Helsingborg ended up with looking like. It is first the ferry station that was built by the northern piece of the harbour, northern side of the harbour, with the line going out towards Ängelholm to the north. You have the stations area, and it continues in there, where you also have the connection to the ferry lines. And on the southern side, and you have the small link there in between. On the southern side, you have the station there, the central station. You have the other things going around, going on, sorry. And you have the harbor piece as well put in. And to the south of it, you have Ramlösa station, which is basically just a normal passenger station, but between these two stations is the big freight yard. But I had to put it, I had to make it much smaller. I think on the track layout I have from the 1920s, there was seven or nine tracks, and that I had to put it on the same place where the station is to manage to get it in. We have added the bridge over the Rohr River, which is basically the river that the train line follows. You put scenery in to create the farmland that's there. Put in some stations area as it looked in the 1940s in Valokra. We have passed Utarp, which makes the, and there we have the weird viaduct thing just to put it where it's supposed to be. Tågarp has its station layout, and Billeberga as well. South of Billeberga, it's only one station on the map here, but we need to add, I think, one more, so I think I will do that at a later stage, because we probably need two meeting points. Passing loops. So you can see Teckomatorp there, where another line crosses, so it's not a very good passing loop to start with. You can see the line going out there to the east on the northern side. Plenty of stations area. I have had to redo that a little bit from the time lapse, because it turned out that there was a crossing missing, so you couldn't actually get over to the freight side from the connection from the northeast. And this one going out to the towards the southwest, sorry. So you couldn't really connect between them in a good way through the freight station, but I fixed that anyway. And here we have the station at Marieholm, where I would probably put in a meeting station as well, since it's quite far to Eslöv without being able to without any passing loops. And at Eslöv they have to go out there to go out, continue to the northern side to turn around again to get into the freight station, which is most peculiar, but that's how the layout is actually, so we will try to live with it. It's going to be very busy, but anyway, that's how it was designed. Let's head out of the depot and get on the line, and let's see if we can figure out out if the design actually worked. So here comes the cab ride, and enjoy the scenery. I believe the bad issues from previous times has been solved, but at least it has gotten a bit better with the lagging issue. I'll try to restart the computer before doing it, and then when opening the game, actually trying to get as much of the game as possible right into the memory by just moving the moving the visible area back and forth. It seems to do to work much better if you do that. It seems. So let's hope it works for the next one as well. So this is the cab ride. Thank you so much for watching.